Hi everyone, I am Professor Shalini. Let's start with new concept of internal combustion engines, that is air standard cycles, fuel air cycles and actual cycles. This is graph showing pressure versus volume. Here we can see that in first stage there is admission of charge, then there is compression, then combustion, then expansion. These both combustion and expansion are taken place adiabatically. Okay, what is meaning of adiabatically? What is meaning of adiabatic process? A process which does not heat transfer takes place. A process in which heat transfer does not take place. Okay, and here there is charge or burn gases accepting the combustion chamber. This is example of basic cycle which takes place. Now let's see next. First there is air standard cycle, which is then corrected for characteristics of fuel air mixture as our need, which forms fuel air cycle. In fuel air cycle there is corrected for losses. There are various losses in dislocation or time factor loss, etc. These are various following types of cycles. Air standard cycle, which includes Carnot cycle, Stirling cycle, Irkeson cycle, Otto cycle, diesel cycle, dual cycle. And next type, air fuel cycles and actual cycle. Here Carnot cycle, Otto cycle is more important. Now we will see Carnot cycle in detail. Okay. In Carnot cycle, first one to three process is isothermal expansion. What is isothermal expansion? Here temperature change is zero. And second step is isentropic expansion. There 2 to 3 process takes place isentropically, and 3 and 4 again is considered as isothermal process, which is compression process. Heat is transferred from one temperature source to constant temperature. In fourth stage, from 4 to 1, isentropic compression takes place. Here expansion continues under isentropic compression. Okay, the pressure and volume ratios are huge in this system, which cannot practice feasible. Hence Otto cycle was invented. Here we can see that SI engine works on Otto cycle. We will see Otto cycle. Here we can see that first is inlet stroke, then as I explained earlier, compression stroke. Here constant volume combustion takes place in chamber, then there is expansion stroke, and then constant volume heat rejection, and there exhaust stroke where all burnt gases moves out. Okay, now power cycle or Otto cycle. This is an important concept. Air standard Otto cycle is an ideal cycle that approximates a spark engine internal combustion engine. It assumes that heat addition occurs initially with the piston at TDC. Here the piston is assumed to at TDC. Here we can see that in 1 and 2, as I said that here process 1 to 2 is here process 1 to 2 E is isentropic compression, that is compression of volume from V1 to V2, and from 2 to 3 E is constant volume. Here V remains constant, which is constant volume heat addition QH. Okay, here ignition of fuel takes place. Here chemical reaction in this 2 to 3 takes place. Okay, and next one is from 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion. Power is delivered where S is constant. Okay, here 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 is considered as adiabatic reversible process. Here 1 to 4 is here 1 to 4 here volume remains constant, here volume remains constant and heat rejection takes place. In this 1 to 4 process here volume V1 and V4 are constant. Okay, now let's see next. As I said, first isentropic compression, then constant volume heat addition, then isentropic expansion, and at last stage constant volume heat rejection process. Okay, this diagram also is PV and TDTS diagrams for ideal Otto cycle. Isentropic heat isentropic compression, constant volume heat addition, then isentropic expansion and constant volume heat rejection. In same way in this TS diagram, first one is here temperature remains constant in first stage, and in 3 to 4 also heat remains constant. Okay, now we will see next. Here we can see in process 1 to 2 an isentropic compression of air takes place as the piston moves from BDC to TDC. Here the fuel compression takes place as piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. In second place, as I said, constant volume heat transfer takes place, due to which the external source piston is at top dead center. This process is intended to represent the ignition of fuel mixture and substitute rapid burning. Here ignition takes place. In third stage there is isentropic expansion. Here expansion takes place as piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center and exhaust gases moves out. Fourth process is constant volume process, where heat is rejected from air with piston at bottom dead center. Okay, now we will see next. Here Otto cycle, here Otto cycle and combustion engine ratio is shown. Next one, it shows the graph of efficiency also is compression ratio. It can be seen that for monoatomic gases efficiency is more, that is lambda is equal to 1.67, for air it is 1.4, and for exhaust gases it is lambda is equal to 1.3. This shows the effect of ratio of compression ratio on Otto cycle efficiency. Okay, next one is air standard cycle, which I said diesel cycle. Okay, here we can see that in process 1 to 2 it is isentropic 1 to 2 is isentropic compression, then constant pressure heat addition. Here pressure remains constant, then isentropic expansion, and fourth stage is constant volume heat rejection. Here compression of charge takes place at constant pressure, heat is added, due to which ignition takes place, and at fourth there is isentropic expansion, and last stage there is heat rejection at constant volume. Okay, dual cycle. In dual cycle both constant volume and constant pressure are used. Here in first stage 1 to 2 there is isentropic compression of charge, then constant volume heat addition, and at constant pressure there is also heat addition, and from 3 to 4 there is isentropic expansion, and 4 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. Here both at constant volume and constant pressure heat addition takes place. Okay, now we will see next type, that is Stirling cycle. It was earlier used for heat air engine, nowadays it is not used in mass section. Here we can see the process is similar, that is 1 to 2 is thermal compression, that is heat is rejected at constant temperature. Isothermal, where temperature remains constant from 1 to 2. Later on, 2 to 3 is constant volume. Here, say 1 to 2 is constant volume where we remain, 2 to 3 is constant volume where volume remains constant, and at constant volume there is compression, and along with it there is heat addition. From 3 to 4 is isothermal expansion. Expansion takes place as piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, and this process takes place at constant temperature. From 4 to 1 there is constant volume again. Volume remains constant. Here expansion along with heat rejection takes place. Here we can say that V1 is equal to V4. Okay. Next one is Erkison cycle. In Erkison cycle, as we can see that in process 1 to 4 it is isothermal process, and here isothermal compression of charge takes place. In 2 to 3 there is constant volume heat addition process. Here constant volume heat addition process takes place from 2 to 3. In 3 to 4 there is isothermal expansion. Expansion takes place as piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center. In 4 to 1 constant pressure heat addition takes place. Here pressure remains constant. Advantages of this cycle can be as smaller pressure ratio over Carnot or Stirling cycle for given ratio of maximum to minimum specific volume. High minimum effective pressure for cycle. Thank you.